This is Drew Pearson, the original 88. I just want to let you know that we both wish you a very Merry Christmas. Car dealers, we're coming after you in 2017. Let's go.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids ding-o-belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer.
As a matter of fact, the only thing we ever won when I was at Tulsa was the coin flip. And that was only on a few occasions. But anyway, because of that negative environment, athletically, academically, I got a great education when I was at Tulsa. And that's what's most important to me now. Because when I open my mouth to speak, people are going to know if I'm educated or not. So education goes a lot further than your athletic career, your playing career. So that's what's the most important. But athletically, we didn't have much success on the field. And because of that lack of success, when the time came for the NFL draft, you know, no one thought Drew Pearson was good enough to waste a draft pick on. Now, this is back when they had 17 rounds of the NFL draft, okay? Back then in 73, they drafted 452 players, and nobody thought Drew Pearson was good enough to waste a draft pick on. Now, I'm almost over that. I'm not as bitter as I used to be about that. You guys, you know about it. You can't dwell on negatives, right? You got to move on and move on in life and move away from that the best you can. So as an undrafted free agent, I had a chance to sign with the Green Bay Packers, the Pittsburgh Steelers, or the Dallas Cowboys. And that really helped because I was really disappointed I didn't get drafted. This was my dream to play in the NFL. And by not getting drafted, they were telling me that I wasn't good enough to play. And so I had a chip on my shoulder the whole time. All I wanted was an opportunity to get in the door. And I knew I wasn't going to Green Bay. Because like I said, academically at Tulsa University, I got a great education. And because of that, I was smart enough to realize that Green Bay was no place for this brother to be trying to catch passes. Okay? You can't catch passes in that cold weather with your hands in your pocket, you know? Look like T.O. Remember T.O. used to run like that? Ball used to beat him up. That was how I would have looked. So I didn't sign with Green Bay, and I didn't sign with the Pittsburgh Steelers because I knew there was a guy out in Southern Cal finishing up his senior year. I knew he wanted to play for the Steelers. I knew he wanted to wear number 88, so I didn't sign with the Steelers so Lynn Swan could have a career in the NFL. All right, he still sends me a check for that. Thank you, Lynn. Like that mailbox money. But anyway, I ended up signing with the Dallas Cowboys, and it wasn't about the money, it was about the opportunity. My first year salary with the mighty, mighty, all-time, world-famous Dallas Cowboys, coached by the great Tom Landry, hut-hut, you know, all these great players, Roger Staubach and Leroy Jordan, Bob Lilly, Mel Renfro, Bob Hayes, wow, Bullet Bob Hayes, all these great players, you know. My first year salary with these mighty, mighty, all-time, world-famous Dallas Cowboys was $14,500. I know, right? For the whole season, $14,500. My signing bonus was $150. 150. That's it. Not 15000 like they get nowadays. So I didn't hold out for $15,000 or $200 signing bonus. I told that scout that was at the Camelot Hotel, 11 o'clock at night. I had a delay getting over there because I was a little disappointed I didn't get drafted, and I was getting full of that Boone's Farm, you know, trying to drown my sorrows. You know that Boone's Farm. You know what I'm talking about. Apple was my favorite. I don't know about you, but so I had to sober up, shower up. I went down to Camelot Hotel. They offered me that, and I told that scout, I said, look here, if you pay me that signing bonus in cash, I'll sign right now. You know, they didn't have no ATMs back then, okay? So that guy must have known he going to get Drew Pearson today. So he went in his pocket. He took out 7 20s and a 10, and he laid it out on the table. And I scooped it up, and that's how I got my signing bonus with the mighty, mighty, all-time, world-famous Dallas Cowboys, coached by the great Tom Landry. 7 20s and a 10, okay? And I was married at the time and went back to the campus apartment and told my, ex-wife, now, we only got $75. She was happy. Oh, my God, $75. And had a party in the dorm with the rest of the Boone Farm with the boys at the dorm, excited and celebrating the fact that and sign with the Cowboys.